Our warrior's katana makes a big hole, even through a male shirt. And as an added bonus, you can throw it as well, as you just saw. Well, there you have it, the most extreme, horrendous testing of a Japanese katana that I've ever even heard of. We've cut through 4-inch tatami mats 500 times. We've cut through 1-inch thick manila rope 500 times. We beat the blade on this steel table. We put the blade and we flexed it in a vise and we bent it like a pretzel. And it's still really useful. Don't spend $150 or $250 or $300 on a sword made by companies that aren't known for quality, that have never proven any of their claims and never will. Buy a sword that will always match your skills. As much as you train, as hard as you train, you deserve a sword that will always equal your skill. As your skill goes up, the sword will meet you at every step on that path up the mountain. A cold steel sword will meet you and be your friend that you can trust on. I can't tell you how easy that was. You have the right angle and a beautiful sword like this with that unbelievably great cross section. That thing just flew through that bamboo. Look how thick this stuff is. Some thick stuff. I love it. The Chinese War Sword by Cold Steel. That's what I love about this Chinese War Sword. Cuts like a bat out of hell. A piece of rope's bigger than my upper arm. Hundreds and hundreds of strands of polyester twine, all braided together. Enormous resistance, but it's no match for our Chinese war sword. That's what a Chinese war sword is all about. We'll be right back.
call.